back to our series of webinars on sustainable aquaculture. In this case, we're going to look at problems with pond bottom sludge. So how is pond bottom sludge formed? This is a combination of leftover feed, which can be, and quite often is, 20%, plus the shrimp or fish feces. This builds up to a toxic sludge in the bottom of the pond, which can lead to numerous problems. So what is the impact of sludge on culture? Sludge is one of the major problems in shrimp and fish culture. Impact on the culture, as well as ammonia and nitrite, which all farmers are aware of, is that there are other hidden problems that can cause slow growth or even death. These are an increase in oxygen demand in the sludge, causing slow growth and, in extreme cases, crop failure. Development of toxic metabolites. These can lead to a greater chance of disease, such as EMS, white spot, and EHP. This is seen in the anaerobic process in the bottom of the pond. Hydrogen sulfides, also in the anaerobic process, sometimes known as a silent killer. Hydrogen sulfide is known to contribute to white feces disease, which is a growing problem in today's culture. Hydrogen sulfide can also turn water black. This is usually associated with excess iron in the water, particularly after heavy rains. This usually results in crop failure. Hydrogen sulfide reduces daily growth and survival rate and will increase FCR. Hydrogen sulfide increases stress and lowers resistance to disease. Safe levels of hydrogen sulfides are very low, much lower than ammonium nitrite. In the case of tiger prawns, it's as low as 0.033 parts per million, and white Pacific shrimp, 0.0087 parts per million. This is, as I said, much, much lower than the ammonia and nitrite. So the impact of sludge drainage on the environment. Current culture methods either leave the sludge in the pond or discharge the environment. If we leave the sludge in the pond, we run the risk of problems outlined in the previous slide, which are not good for the farmer. If we discharge sludge in the environment without treatment, this is also leads to accumulating environmental problems, which can make culture more and more difficult. These include contamination of the environment with toxic metabolites that can cause disease in surrounding farms, and even recontamination of the discharging farm under the right conditions. These toxic metabolites can lead to favorable conditions for EMS, white spot, EHP, and other diseases to develop. Discharge of sludge can lead to release of hydrogen sulfide in the environment, which can be taken back into the ponds if makeup water is not treated. Sludge discharge also introduces high COD into the environment, which can lead to reduced oxygen in the water. Discharge sludge is also high in nutrient, which can lead to toxic algae blooms under the right conditions. Toxic sludge buildup can lead to mass deaths of indigenous aquatic organisms, which is not good for the industry and is increasingly bringing the attention of authorities. So we're going to look at what AquaCal can do now. We have we call this the Struvite displacement reaction on the impact on the sludge digestion. AquaCal is a flocculant that forms a compact sludge. As well as other benefits in the water table, introduction of AquaCal Plus also has the following benefits to the pond bottom sludge. The consumption of ammonia and phosphate from the aerobic sludge digestion process results in the formation of struvite, accompanied by the release of hydroxide ions, allowing the sludge to maintain the anaerobic digestion process as long as the particles of magnesium hydroxide or AquaCal Plus are available within this sludge. Hence, AquaCal Plus improves the degree of sludge digestion and reduces the formation of hydrogen sulfide and pathogens such as Vibrio. This is achieved by suppression of the anaerobic digestion and the ability of AquaCal to inhibit pathogen growth. And we mentioned Struvite before. This is how the Struvite mechanism works. In the pond bottom sludge, we have two systems going at basically the same time: the anaerobic system and the aerobic system. Now, the anaerobic system produces hydrogen sulfide and pathogens, which ultimately can result in death of your culture animal. The anaerobic digestion system also has its own problems. Even with the introduction of probiotics, we try to get the anaerobic system going much more quickly. This is because digestion is better in anaerobics than anaerobic. As you can see, the byproducts of an aerobic digestion system is ammonia and phosphate. Now, ammonia will, by nitrification, go to the nitrite, which in high levels is toxic for your organisms. Also, we can produce bad algae, which again is toxic for your organisms. With the addition of AquaCal Plus, we make a product called Struvite. This is magnesium ammonium phosphate, which is actually a slow release fertilizer. This leads to the removal of the ammonia and the phosphate from the system, and good algae growth in the form of green algae, which in early culture is food for your shrimp and fish. We're looking here at a couple of examples. These are discharges from experimental shrimp ponds. As you can see in the first slide, we see a layer of oil and fats on the discharge after normal culture. In the next slide on the right, we see discharge after a treatment of AquaCal. It shows the breakdown of fats and oils of the organic products. In other words, it is a clean discharge. Oh, now we're looking at the reduction in hydrogen sulfide and the sludge volumes. On the top slide, or the top photograph, a colleague has gone down to the pond bottom and he's doing what we call the smell test for in the sludge. In a normal drained pond after culture, the hydrogen sulfide will almost be overpowering, so you couldn't do this. In this case, there was no smell. Most of the organics has been digested. We can also see on the bottom photograph that the volume of sludge is much reduced. This is in an overdrained pond, and we've reduced the volume of sludge quite significantly. The white color is diffraction of light from the AquaCal Plus particles still contained in that sludge, so they're still active. We did a series of laboratory tests looking at digestion of sludge and the green Vibrio. These were done in a laboratory in Malaysia. So we've taken a control which has probiotic and with no aeration. The second control was probiotic with aeration. And we have AquaCal with no aeration and AquaCal with aeration. As we can see, the sludge digestion results are quite significantly different. The first control with no aeration is 23.4% sludge digestion. The control with aeration is better, it's 42.8%. However, when we look at the AquaCal, the first AquaCal with no aeration is 59.5% and 68.3% with aeration. This test was done over 120 days and shows significantly more digestion using AquaCal. In the next chart, we have actually looked at alkalinity. We've seen basically in control one and two, there's not much change in alkalinity. But in AquaCal, we actually increased the alkalinity to 195 and 220. This is very good because later in the culture, more alkalinity is required for shrimp, around 200 parts per million. The more important one is the green vibrio. In our initial reading, we saw a reading of 170 colonies of green vibrio in our water. With the control one and two, we see that they've dropped down a little, 120 and 110. But in AquaCal, there was no colonies of green vibrio seen at the end of the test. Again, this was 120 days. So in summary, as we can see, AquaCal has several beneficial effects on pond bottom sludge. By treating the sludge while contained in the pond bottom, we also help the environment by not discharging toxins and other harmful contaminants. We are effectively treating the pond bottom sludge, at the same time helping the economics of the farm by producing beneficial algae, which prawns will feed on, particularly in the early stage of development, and thus reduce FCR and grow healthy and active prawns. Calix is continuing improving our culture methods to reduce environmental impact and support sustainable aquaculture. We thank you for your attention, and for further information, you can contact our partners and distributors. For Malaysia, Vietnam, and Thailand, this is Maha Chemicals. The contact is Dennis Toll. Dennis's email is shown on the screen. For China, Taiwan, and Indonesia, this is Honlex Jones. Contact is Simon Tam. His contact is shown on the screen. For India, this is Three Little Fishes. Contact is Sagania Vijayan. Her contact is shown on the screen. Once again, we thank you for your attention. We hope you will view our future webinars. If you wish to contact me directly, you can contact me via my email, which is shown below, or you can contact Calix via our website, which is www.calix.global. Thank you, and look forward to seeing you at our next webinar.